Today you learn how to design a wedding template as someone requested in the comments. Let me know what you would like to see too. I chose my document to be the shape of a rectangle. Create a circle with the ellipse tool and move it in the right up corner. Choose 4 photos you want to use in your design. Over the circle, move one photo, click right, choose Create Clip Mask. Ctrl plus D, change its size. For now, I choose a light blue for the background. In the end, I will make it white, so to make it easier for you, you can already make it white. Choose your circle in layers, press on ellipse tool, and now you can make the stroke bigger and wide. Now click right, choose blending options and check drop shadow. Play around until you get the desired shadow. Now, with custom shape, make a heart. Make stroke wide and bigger. Ctrl plus D, click right and rotate. I think another shadow will look better on this heart, so I change it. Now I duplicate the heart, rotate it and make it bigger. Ctrl plus D and change its size. Repeat this step, but this time make it smaller. Now move one of your photos over one of your hearts, click right, create clipping mask, Ctrl plus D and make it smaller. Here I realize I have two photos with flowers and one with a ring, so I remove the photo with the ring in the middle heart. So yeah, I had to make some adjustments to make it fit inside the middle heart. Click right on it in the layer sections and choose creating clipping mask. If needed, Ctrl plus D and change its size. My photos, as you can see, are not from the same wedding, so because the flowers are not the same as the girl's ones, I moved the heart a little bit to cover her flowers. Now I will make some color adjustments to the photos so they look alike. If you will make the design for a real wedding, you will not have these problems, but it's important to try to have the same vibe from each photo you use. This can change the whole aspect of the design. I want the background to have some hearts. My idea is to create a heart with custom shape tool. Go to blending options, check gradient, and this should be formed from a pink and the color of the background. Right now it's a light blue, but if you already used white, put now white instead of a light blue. Make some adjustments until the heart looks the way you want. Make the opacity lower. Now, just duplicate the heart as many times as you think it looks good, and of course, move all the hearts around. Make some of them smaller. Rotate them. Ctrl plus T on your keyboard, click right and choose rotate. Because I didn't like the overall aspect, I changed the background to white. And I had to change the hearts too. Allow me to correct the mistake. Copy layer style and after that paste layer style to all your hearts. Now it's time for the text. Make a small circle with ellipse tool between their names. And right end with white. Add a subtitle. Also, I changed the color of the text. We'll be right back. Add some light with a white soft brown brush and make the opacity lower. If you think it's necessary, cut the template a little bit. Another important step, I think, it's adding an effect. Go to Filter, Camera Raw, and make the right adjustments for your photo. A last touch will be going to Filter Sharpen. See you next week. Subscribe so you won't miss the next tutorial.